Hello and welcome to a new video on the Crypto2 YouTube channel. In this video, I want to show you how you can break the famous double columnar transposition challenge. For this video, I created also some slides. First, I want to show you the double columnar transposition cipher and how it works. After that, I want to give you a short history of the famous double columnar transposition challenge. Then I want to show you an attack on the double columnar transposition cipher invented by George Lasry. And finally, we will have a look at how we can do this in Crypto2. The double columnar transposition cipher was one of the most secure hand ciphers, which was used in Second World War and in the Cold War. In Second World War, it was used by both sides. There was no known solutions for many years for the double columnar transposition and also for the double columnar transposition challenge. And the challenge then was solved first in 2013 by George Lasry. The double columnar transposition cipher itself is a columnar transposition cipher that is performed twice. So first you encrypt the text using a first keyword, and then you encrypt the intermediate ciphertext using a second keyword. If you're interested in the single columnar transposition cipher, I suggest that you have a look at the video I previously created on the single columnar transposition cipher. Here's an example how you can encrypt using the double columnar transposition cipher. You use first the keyword one and write it on top of your text. And you write the text like this is a secret text encrypted by the double columnar transposition cipher. Then you transpose the text using the columnar transposition cipher by ordering the keyword by its alphabetical order. For instance, here you have D, E, K, O, R, W, Y, and this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then you read out column-wise. You can see this here. We made colors that are fitting to the columns. And then you can see you read it out like this. And then, of course, you write on top the second keyword, secret, here. And finally, you order the second keyword also by its alphabetical order, like this here, C, E, E, R, S, T, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you get your final ciphertext by, again, reading out it column-wise. And in fact, this is a really, really secure cipher. It is really hard to break because you have two transpositions. And people thought it's impossible to break it because you first have to remove the second transposition and then remove the first transposition. The problem here is if the keywords or the length of the keywords have no common divisors, then the resulting keyword for a single columnar transposition cipher that performs the same encryption as the double columnar transposition cipher has a keyword length of the multiplication of the length of both keywords. So if you have a keyword length of 10 and a keyword length of 10, then you multiply it to a keyword length of 100. Clearly, here the keyword length 10 and 10, they have the same common divisors. Then, for instance, you have to use 10 and 11, and then you have 110, and you cannot break the cipher then more easily because 10 and 11 have different divisors. So what is the key space size of the double columnar transposition cipher? First of all, let's assume that the length of both keywords have no common divisors. Then the first transposition has a keyword of length n, and the second transposition cipher has a keyword of length m. We know that a transposition cipher key space is the factorial of the length of the keywords, so the first transposition cipher has keyword length or key space size n factorial, and the second one has m factorial. And to get the overall key space size, you have to multiply both key space sizes. So you multiply n factorial with m factorial. And we have an example here with n equals to 20 and m equals to 23, we have a key space size of about 2 to the power of 136. This is more than a modern AES 128 cipher has. So it's a really difficult cipher. So let's come to the history of the double columnar transposition challenge. We have three people involved in that challenge. First, we have Otto Leiberich, then we have Klaus Schmeh, and finally we have George Lasry. So Otto Leiberich was a founder and former head of the Bundesamt für Sicherheit in der Informationstechnik, or short BSI, which is in English the Federal Bureau for Security and Information Technology of Germany. And he suggested that double columnar transposition challenge to encourage research on the cipher already in 1999. So he said people should create a challenge to encourage the researchers to try to break the cipher, because he knew that it's a very, very strong cipher and that it was not broken, and he wanted to see if people were able, using, for instance, modern computing techniques, in breaking this. Then Klaus Schmeh created the actual challenge. Klaus Schmeh is a computer scientist and crypto expert, crypto author and blogger. I will make a link to his blog below this video, so you can have a look at his blog. It's very interesting. He blogs very often and he has very interesting cryptological topics. And as I already said, he created the challenge based on Leiberich's idea in 2007. And then it took 6 years to be solved. And that was George Lasry, who's from Israel. He's a computer scientist and he's right now well known as a code breaker, or as the code breaker for classical cryptology. He solved the challenge after these 6 years in 2013 by developing a new cost function, which is called the IDP, that allowed to attack both transpositions independently. This is a divide and conquer attack that he developed. So how does the attack that George Lasry developed, and we published the attack together with him, work? So the basic idea of George Lasry's attack is the following. First, revert the second transposition by finding keyword 2, and then revert the first transposition by finding keyword 1. This is a mistake here, this is K2 and this is K1. And he invented a new cost function that is called the index of digraphic potential, or short IDP. And this index of digraphic potential allows to hill climb on the second key while ignoring the first transposition. And the basic idea, and it's really great, of the IDP is that you first decrypt a ciphertext using a putative keyword that you assume is the right one, K2. And then for each column of the intermediate ciphertext that you get by decrypting using this keyword, you find the best matching other columns for each column by calculating the bigram values of these. So you take the first column and you search for the best column that you put on the right side of that column, and then you compute the bigram values. And you search for the best columns for each column in your ciphertext. And in the end, you sum all of the bigrams of all best matching columns, and this final sum is the IDP of K2. So this IDP tells you how good is the keyword that you currently have, for instance with hill climbing, by just comparing these bigram, adding these bigram values. And you can get better and better with your keyword, because the IDP gets better the keyword is. And this can be used, for instance, with hill climbing or with a dictionary attack that we see later in this video. And now let's do it in Crypto 2. We have two tasks. The first task is we want to encrypt and decrypt using the double columnar transposition cipher. And then our second task is, of course, we want to break the famous double columnar transposition challenge using Crypto 2. I'm here now in Crypto 2, and first I want to show you how you can double encrypt using the columnar transposition cipher. To do so, we start a new workspace by clicking on this icon here. And then we make some more space by closing this here. Then we search for the transposition cipher and drag and drop it once on our workspace. Now let's have a look what the transposition cipher needs. It needs an iCrypto stream for plain or ciphertext, and it needs a keyword. And it outputs also an iCrypto stream. So we first need text input for our plain text. Name this plain text. And we write something like. Then we need a converter to convert from text to crypto stream. Say here, in the settings, crypto stream. And we connect the converter to the text input, which is our plain text here. And the converter then with the input of the transposition cipher. Now we need a keyword. So we need another text input. And this here will be our keyword one. And this is double. And we also connect this to the transposition cipher. Now for the second transposition, we need all that are already created here. So we just mark everything, use Ctrl C and Ctrl V, and copied it here. Then we don't need this here, and we use this as keyword 2. And this is transposition. And we don't need this. And we connect the first transposition cipher to the second transposition cipher. We also want to see the intermediate cipher text, so we add an additional text output and name this intermediate cipher text. And of course we connect this to a converter, because we need to convert from crypto stream to text. And we connect the converter to the intermediate cipher text, and we set this converting to a string. This is converting to crypto stream. And then, of course, we want to see the final ciphertext. So, ciphertext. And we just copy the converter, connect everything, and we have our final ciphertext. So, what does happen here if I start it? First, the plain text is converted to a crypto stream, then transposed by the first transposition cipher. Then again transposed by the second transposition cipher. The first uses the keyword 1, the second uses the keyword 2. And we get the intermediate ciphertext and the final ciphertext. So let's test it by just clicking play. Here is our intermediate ciphertext and here is our final ciphertext. Now let's test if we also can decrypt using the double columnar transposition. So we stop this here. We copy our ciphertext to our plain text text input here, but of course this time this is ciphertext, and of course we have to exchange the keywords. So we have to first decrypt with transposition and then decrypt with double, and of course we have to change our transposition ciphers to decrypt mode or action. Let's give it a try. And as you can see here again, we have the same intermediate ciphertext because we reworded the first transposition using the keyword transposition. And then we decrypted using the second transposition cipher with the keyword double. And finally, we have this as a test of the double columnar transposition cipher. So you can create a double columnar transposition cipher in Crypto 2 using two transposition ciphers. In the next step, I want to show you how you can actually break the famous double columnar transposition challenge. We are now back in the start center of Crypto 2, and I want to show you how you can break the double columnar transposition challenge, or the Doppelwürfel. To do so, we search here for double columnar transposition cipher, and we see a template that we already created that's named Dictionary Attack on the Double Columnar Transposition Cipher. And you just double click on that template. So what do we have here? First, we have the ciphertext here, which has 599 letters. And this here is the original ciphertext that Klaus Schmeh created for the double columnar transposition challenge that George Lasry solved. So what else do we have? We have the IDP analyzer. What the IDP is, I already explained at the beginning of the video. So in the first step, the ciphertext will be analyzed using our IDP analyzer, and the second keyword is stripped away from our ciphertext. Then the intermediate ciphertext you will see here. And the intermediate ciphertext then goes to our transposition analyzer. And the transposition analyzer then will strip off or decrypt or break the ciphertext, and it will get rid of the keyword 1. And here you will see the final decrypted ciphertext. So let's have a look at the IDP analyzer. The IDP analyzer has two modes. it has a dictionary search and the hill climbing attack. And you have to specify the keyword length you want to analyze. In our case, the key sizes for key 1 is between 20 and 27, and the key size for key 2 is between 23 and 23. Then in the transposition analyzer, you can change the analysis mode. We set it to hill climbing. You have to test here different key sizes. We know that the key size is 21, so I leave it like this. Then you can change parameters like the cost function and how the transposition cipher behaves, but we don't change anything here because it's set up in the right way. So now let's start and let's see how fast we can break the famous double columnar transposition cipher challenge by just clicking on play. As you can see here, we'll make full screen. It analyzes and it found a key phrase, preponderance of evidence. That key phrase came from a dictionary. Clearly, we have a dictionary that's not very huge. Otherwise, you would need much more time to analyze the double columnar transposition challenge. But since this is a short video and Crypto2 is an e-learning tool, we don't want to have people sitting hours and hours in front of the PC and wait for this. Yeah, and as you can see here, the transposition analyzer then took the intermediate ciphertext and it broke the first transposition cipher. And here you can see the final text. The final text is the girl had arrived at Lupton House and so on. So this text was taken from a book. If you want to know more about that text and about the story behind the breaking of the double columnar transposition cipher, I suggest you to read the aforementioned paper. So as you see, you can easily break the famous double columnar transposition challenge using Crypto2. And this was everything that I wanted to show you in this short video. I hope you liked it. If yes, please give a thumbs up. And also, if you did not yet subscribe to our channel, I would be also happy if you subscribe to our channel. And see you in the next video.